Hi, I'm Rick with TGW.com. I'm introducing the new Cobra Darkspeed Max driver. It's my intent to tell you what type of player is going to want to try this particular driver. I got to hit this one for the first time. I'll go over my experiences, and then I'll touch on just a little bit of the key technology and features that go into this great new driver from Cobra. Listed are the standard specifications. You can see there are three different loft options available, starting as low as 9 degrees. There's a 10.5 and a 12. All three of the drivers are adjustable with the hosel sleeve. Players can adjust the loft plus or minus up to 1.5 degrees, and players can put the club into a more upright or draw position. I got to hit this club with the new UST LinQ Red graphite shaft and the Lampkin 360 standard stock rubber grip. But remember, TGW will accommodate any of your custom requests. There are three different driver models in the new Darkspeed lineup. The Darkspeed LS is designed typically for a better player with higher club head speed who wants a more tour-inspired shape. That's going to provide a lower launch with lower spin, more workability, and maximum tunability. The Darkspeed X is a very versatile driver. It's going to create a medium launch and plenty of forgiveness. This is the Darkspeed Max. It's designed to help players play better by reducing either their slight miss to the right or the major miss to the right. When getting to hit this club for the first time, I really like the look of all the Darkspeed products. I like the matte black finish. I think it makes the club set up clean at address. It helps the golf ball stand out, and it reduces any distractions from glare or reflections that you might get from the crown of the club. At impact, this club provided a slightly more resonating and higher pitch snap. All of the Darkspeed drivers I was swinging at maybe slightly above average at 102 miles an hour. This particular Darkspeed Max was giving me an average ball speed of 144 plus miles an hour. I was launching the 9-degree driver at just over 11 degrees, had an appropriate spin rate of 2,500 RPMs. That gave me a nice penetrating trajectory of 76 feet, a shallow descent angle of 34 degrees, and an average carry distance of 241 yards. With the heavy weight in the back of the club, on average, my shot dispersion was approximately 17 yards left. After hitting it, I moved the heavy weight into the heel, and that added another 7 yards of draw bias to my shot pattern. The new Darkspeed Max driver has a redefined aerodynamic design, which I do believe helped me increase my club head speed. More club head speed is going to equal more distance. Cobra's using a 10% larger Power Shell L Cup face on the new Darkspeed Max driver. It's going to enhance ball speeds and create more distance. And with the new AI designed hot variable thickness face, that's going to maintain ball speeds and spin rates across the face, making your heel and toe shots react more like your centered shots. The carbon crown on the new Darkspeed Max driver helps to lower and move the center of gravity further back in the club, creating a higher MOI for more forgiveness and tighter dispersion. And with the tunability on the sole of the club, players can take this club from a medium draw bias into a maximum draw bias. So if the new Darkspeed Max driver sounds like it might be a good fit for your game and you want to give it a shot, please do. TGW.com offers a 30-day mulligan buyback on any standard stock orders and up to 90 days when you configure a custom order. Tunable draw bias and low spin for distance and accuracy. This is the new Darkspeed Max driver from Cobra. Check it out. Check out our other product review videos at TGW.com.